Hi, I'm Peter Travers, and this is Popcorn, where we tell you what's happening at the movies. And a major happening right now in terms of Oscar buzz is a movie called The Fighter, starring Mark Wahlberg and Christian Bale. Mark and Christian will be with us in just a minute to tell us some behind-the-scenes stuff that went on in the movie. But first, let's take a look at Mark Wahlberg and Christian Bale in action in The Fighter.
I made a promise to them I wouldn't work with you again. I had to. After everything that happened, I'm sorry.
You sticking to that?
I'm glad you're back. You look good. I don't know what else to say.
Christian Bale, Mark Wahlberg.
Hello.
Welcome. Let's just begin then by saying to those benighted souls out there that haven't seen The Fighter yet, I can't believe that anybody exists that hasn't been there yet, but since it just opened, they probably haven't had a chance yet.
You can forgive them.
Who do each of you play? Mark, who are you playing?
I play Irish Mickey Ward, who was his character's younger brother, living in his shadow.
I played Dickie Eklund, who is the older brother, and the guy that Mickey always looked up to and who inspired Mickey to get into boxing, but then kind of confused Mickey when Dickie went off the rails and enjoyed the party life and street life a little too much and ended up on crack and ended up in jail.
Scared and embarrassed because you don't even have a plan on my brother. Just tell me.
You got to run against this guy. Let him punch himself out. Take him to the body, right? Get inside. Switch stances like you're going to work his right. Hit him on the left.
You ain't me. All right, you can't be me. You had a hard enough time being you when you had your chance, and that's why you're in here. All right? I'll fight Sanchez the way I fight.
And it's not primarily a boxing movie. This is mainly a movie. Boxing's the backdrop. It's mainly a movie about the love of these two brothers and the loyalty of a family and Mickey's ability to redefine that relationship so that he can actually succeed because the family is claustrophobically loving, you know?
Well, loving in the sense of all those sisters that are, I mean, they, whoa.
Yeah. Who are the scariest people in the movie?
I wouldn't want to get in the ring with them.
Forget the ring. You don't want to mess with them outside the ring anywhere. You know?
It's so funny because when we showed the movie in Lowell, we were going to introduce the movie, and I had a microphone in my hand, and I said, the sisters hadn't seen it yet, and I said, if you guys have any issues that you want to address, either verbally or physically, you can see Mr. Earl Russell after the movie. And he was not happy about that. But they did end up, enjoying the movie very much. But it's obviously hard, seeing your life up on the big screen.
Well, that's what I wanted to say, because you both were very eloquent describing who you're playing. But these people aren't characters that were invented by a screenwriter, but mm-hmm. real people. Mm-hmm. Real people that are still around that you two were talking to.
Yeah, well, certainly mm-hmm. Mickey and Dickie were very much involved in the process. Mm-hmm. I mean, they lived in my house for quite some time. We trained together. They knew what our intentions were, and our intentions were to show them in a heroic light that they deserve. Despite all the ups and downs and the adversity that they had to overcome, their story is very inspirational.
Did they have anything to say about the script when it was just the script? Were they able to look at it and say, look, not this, what
they
are you talking about?
They didn't read the script. There was a point in time where I left some pages, and it wasn't like the shooting script, but it was stuff that Dave was working on. I left it on the table, and Dickie picked it up, and he was not happy about it, and he threatened to punch David out, but we talked him down. And
David being David O'Russell.
David O'Russell, yes,
the director. Your director, yes. Who has his own reputation for being a tough guy.
Misunderstood.
Unfair? Misunderstood.
Misunderstood. I mean, he's a passionate guy, but he's a loving and sweet man, and if he ever lost his cool, I can tell you he's very embarrassed about that.
Mm-hmm. And it didn't happen one time. I mean, I know that there were a bunch of people saying, oh, it's Mark. Oh, it's David O. Russell. Oh, it's Christian. Oh, what's going to happen on that set? Was like that Coke. It was like that Coke commercial. I'd like to teach the world to sing. It was like the happiest set I've ever been on. It was
like
fantastic.
What a wonderful world.
It was kind of ridiculously happy.
Yes.
But what were the stumbling blocks to it? originally, before Christian even came along as Dickie, when you were talking to other actors, when you were talking to Brad Pitt or Matt Damon, what and it was a different director. It was Aronofsky.
Did anybody get as far as meeting Dickie?
No. They had seen the videos of them, but I don't think Matt or Brad met Dickie. I don't know. Maybe it was the script itself. I thought we had a pretty good script. It's not the script we ended up making, because David obviously added his thing to it. He brought out the humor, a lot more of the emotion, and the female roles were, aside from Alice, were pretty much non-existent. Certainly the Charlene roles and the sisters weren't even in the movie. And but it's not the kind of thing where you say, okay, you 2 weeks out, you start learning your lines, you show up on the set. It's a big commitment. And I remember seeing Christian, and I immediately thought about The Machinist and Rescue Dawn, and you know, I was like, we gotta see if this guy is interested in the material, and he responded.
He thought
right
we've
away.
Got a loopy one here. He might just do it.
Yeah,
exactly. He might just go
he
the
might
distance.
Take this
really.
On.
But what Mark was talking about with the humor is like, I mean, you can't have a story about Mickey and Dickie without humor. You know, because, and that's why David was so perfect for it, because he can be so very serious and he can be so completely silly as well, all at the same time. And I think that's what makes his movies really interesting.
I want to know what Mickey said to you and what Dickie said to you the first time they saw the movie.
I remember what Dickie said to me. Dickie goes,
you
wow.
You remember Dickie? Okay.
Yeah, Dickie goes, wow, Mickey looks like $1 million, I look like a $2 bill. And I said, dude, trust me. You know, wait until you see it with an audience and you see people's reaction to the movie. You're the real inspiration in this movie. You had to overcome so many other obstacles. And you know what you did? You passed the torch to your brother. And that is a big deal. And when he saw it with an audience, he got it.
Dickie patted me on the knee, went, you f***er, like that. And then gave me a big hug and went, you nailed it.